What's the difference between decision trees, random forests, and gradient boosting? Let's find out. Hey everyone, welcome to the channel. My name's Leon. So decision tree based algorithms are now very popular thanks to their efficiency and also their prediction performance. An example would be XGBoost that's already helped win a lot of Kaggle competitions. And before you can understand how these algorithms work, you need to understand the difference between decision trees, random forests, and also gradient boosting. So here are the timestamps in case you want to skip ahead. In this video, I'm going to go over at a high level what the differences are, because even sometimes I forget. Let's get right into it. So decision trees are very, very simple predictors. Basically, they represent a series of conditional steps that you need to take in order to make a decision. As a very basic example, let's say I'm trying to decide whether or not it's worth buying a new phone, and I have this very simple decision tree to help me decide. The first and only question is, does my current phone still work? Well, yes, it does. So according to this decision tree, that's it. I don't need to buy a new phone. Now, would something as simple as this actually be useful in modeling the problem? Probably not, because there's a lot of other factors to take into account than just whether or not my current phone is still working. So instead, we can have a more complex decision tree like this one, which asks, does my phone still work? Which, yes, it does. Do I still have enough memory capacity to record videos and take photos? No, not really. And then we move further down. Do I have enough disposable income to buy a new phone? Yeah, I do. So then the decision would be to buy a new phone according to this decision tree. Now, in this example, you can see that if we wanted to keep going further and further down the tree, we can easily do that just by adding more questions. Or if we wanted to make the tree simpler, then we would just remove some of the questions from the tree. They're very easy to use and they provide a clear visual for making decisions. And they're also very easy to build computationally as well. However, there's some serious disadvantages to this simplicity. The main one being overfitting, so it performs extremely well on one dataset, but if you try to generalize this model on other datasets, then it performs very poorly. You can see in the example I showed, the further down the tree you go, the more specific that tree becomes for that particular situation. Also, depending on the question you start building the decision tree with, the final decision tree can end up looking very different. So in the end, despite them being easy to build, you wouldn't use a decision tree by itself to make generalized predictions with. And this brings us on to random forests. Now, random forests use a concept called collective intelligence. It builds a bunch of decision trees independently, which are simple predictors, and aggregates their results into a single result. This collective result should, in theory, be closer to the true result that we're looking for. As I said earlier, decision trees can look very different depending on the data it uses. Random forests will try to randomize the construction of trees to try and get a variety of different predictions. However, random forests are harder to interpret because they're a group of decision trees. They're not just a single decision tree anymore. And they're also slower to build because the algorithm needs to build and evaluate each decision tree independently. Now, like random forests, we also have something called gradient boosting, which is also a collection of decision trees. The main difference between random forests and gradient boosting lies in how the trees are created and also how they're aggregated. The trees in gradient boosting are built additively, meaning that each tree is built one after another, and each tree is built to improve on the deficiencies of the previous trees. This whole concept is called boosting. The gradient part of gradient boosting comes from minimizing the gradient of the loss function. If that doesn't make any sense, then don't worry too much about that. The main point is that the trees are built one at a time to improve the overall model instead of being built independently. Another key difference between random forests and gradient boosting is how they aggregate the results. In gradient boosting, instead of aggregating the results at the end of the process, it aggregates the results along the way to calculate the final result. Overall, gradient boosting usually performs better than random forests, but they're prone to overfitting if you don't tune the parameters very carefully. They're also very sensitive to outliers, so if your data has a lot of noise, then gradient boosting might not do very well. So hopefully this video helps clarify the differences between decision trees, random forests, and gradient boosting. Gradient boosting is really popular nowadays, so I think it's worth knowing what the differences are. I've got more beginner data science videos up here somewhere that you can check out as well. And if you want to stay updated, please like and subscribe, turn on the notification bell, and I'll see you in the next one.